in the lab, doing stuff, making something.
It's Fran, and this is my editing computer. It's an HP Omen, and although it is wicked fast and does the job really well, it has this red badge that is just really annoying me to no end, and I really want to change it out for a custom badge that'll be good for the Fran Lab editing computer. Just prying off the face and have to unplug the wiring harness from the computer for the LED backlight. And there you go. There's the culprit. I take it over to the bench, and it was actually quite involved getting the front apart. I had to figure out exactly how they put it together, but it turned out that the front piece was actually two different pieces that were sort of snapped together, so I had to get inside and get all the snaps unsnapped and pull the two pieces apart. There you go. Now the badge is stuck to an LED panel that is held in by two screws, and I actually found that it's actually a Mylar sort of transfer, and I could pull it off, and the LED backlight panel is actually adhesive fronted, so this Mylar piece, it just stuck right to it. Yep. And it was also sort of slightly, smoked. So started to make my own. So I just went to Photoshop and created a template based on the size of the badge that was already in the computer. Created a square of the right size, and then I rotated it 45 degrees, and so I could put my logo in and get it centered. And a little fidgeting and stretching and sort of distorting, I got the Fran Lab F about the right shape and spot and location in the badge where I wanted it. And I had to figure out exactly how I was going to do this, because I knew that I wanted it to be like a plastic outer coat, but I also knew that printing this out with this really bright LED backlight, it was probably going to show through. So I made two prints, one in paper and one on a transfer sheet, one of my clear transfer sheets. I'm using double-sided tape around the perimeter, which I've sped up here, to laminate the two together. So I've reverse printed on the clear sheet, and doubling this up, this makes like a thick black all around the logo, so that that really bright backlight will shine through the paper, illuminate the paper, and also I get double thick ink. So you see the backlight there, shouldn't be a problem. Really all that was left was to trim it down to size. You know, I've got this thick sandwich of paper and plastic transfer sheeting. Did all this with the inkjet. I think I showed this before many times about how I do the transfer sheet with inkjet. And there it is, my replacement. Yep. And because that panel has already got sticky stuff on it, I really just had to center it and push it in place. There really wasn't much tolerance around the outside because this was a really tight fit, so I wasn't able to make the logo larger like I really wanted to, because it goes right up against a hard plastic ridge. And so it sort of had to be exactly the same size as the hole, which wasn't ideal, but did fit. So just had to snap it all together. Yep. One final snap. There you go. It's in place. Just gotta hook it back up. Put the wiring harness back through and snap the front plate on. And I had to reconnect that little wiring harness to the circuit board so that it will illuminate. All right. get the cover back on. All right, time to just fire it up. Fire to the wire. Here you go. And it's done. Thanks to everyone on Patreon for supporting the channel. You know, I appreciate it. You make all these videos possible. I'm Fran. I'll be back here real soon. Bye!
In the lab. It's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. In my lab. Where I work. Watching. Fran Lab. It's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.